Hindsight is a wonderful thing, and if we could look to the future, there are probably decisions that we'd all change in advance. Unfortunately, that's not the case, and it's even more prominent inside the military, where large numbers of money are frequently spent on maybe not the best decisions. We're not talking hundreds, thousands, or even millions of dollars here. Ready to jump into some of the biggest wastes of billions of dollars in all of history? Before we dive into it, do you like videos full of interesting facts? Check out our friends over at Brainiac, who are serving up freshly squeezed brain juice every week. When it comes to aircraft, a Category 1 flaw isn't something that sounds particularly healthy, so you might agree that it was in the U.S. military's interest to hold back on releasing the F-35 Joint Strike fighter plane. For the time being, the U.S. has effectively held fire on producing this aircraft, but it's cost taxpayers $400 billion for the production so far. If one of the military's new F-35 stealth fighters had to climb at a steep angle in order to dodge an enemy attack, design flaws meant the plane might suddenly tumble out of control and crash. Issues like delays, rising costs, design problems, and technical glitches have only added to the weight. Human terrain teams, which blended civilian academics with military personnel, were intended to help soldiers better understand the battlefield. However, with a total cost to taxpayers of around $600 million, it's not looking like it's been much help at all. During this 7-year period, more than 1,000 personnel were deployed from 2007 to 2014, and at a total cost of nearly $750 million. This makes the human terrain system the largest investment in a single social science project in U.S. government history. The human terrain system has been surrounded by controversy and has become the subject of heavy criticism from many different fields of experts. Let's jump back in time for this next waste of money, all the way back to 1940s Germany. We're talking about the Atlantic Wall, a supposedly invasion-proof barrier that would stretch along the coast from northern Norway to France's border with Spain, spanning a huge 2,400 miles in length. Germany ordered the construction of the world's second-largest fortified barrier, second only to the 5,500-mile-long Great Wall of China, in an attempt to stop anyone invading the European continent. Money was no object for the country at the time, which is why a modern equivalent would have set Germany back a huge $206 billion. In actual fact, it was defeated in a matter of minutes on D-Day, much to the dismay of the tens of thousands of people who dedicated 2 years to building it up. You'll often hear military equipment described as being cheap or inexpensive, but it's important to keep in mind that all of these figures are relative to the overall cost in mind. So when the Navy blew $30 billion on a fleet of cheap ships, they weren't actually that cheap after all. We're talking about the literal combat ship. It has consumed tens of billions, while producing only a handful of ships capable of even leaving the port. In 2019, all it has to show for all that time and money is 10 combat-ready ships, only 4 of which the Navy actually intends to deploy over the next year. The Strategic Defense Initiative has been nicknamed a Star Wars system and was supposed to be a space-based system of lasers and satellites that would shoot down any Russian intercontinental or submarine-launched nuclear missile headed toward the United States. Back in 1984, President Reagan's Strategic Defense Initiative estimated the final cost of a United States space defense system at $400 to $800 billion. This ambitious and costly program is now in its fourth decade, having consumed $209 billion while never being tested, even on a limited scale in the heat of battle. Not all expensive weapons are done with harm and attack in mind. The Green Navy was a shift to use green-based energy for the Navy, helping the planet and creating less waste and gases. Sadly, these things come at a higher cost than most traditional methods of powering ships. The biofuels used in a Navy's Green Fleet demonstration in 2012 ran at about $27 per gallon, compared to about $3.50 per gallon for conventional fuels at the time. Conventional fuel costs around $500 per metric ton, but the Mason's biofuel blend costs $675 per metric ton. So you can see why this idea never really took off across the nation. The USS Gerald Ford class carriers were another costly mistake. The first issue appeared in May 2018 when a ship had to return to port early. The ship experienced a propulsion system issue, and the problems didn't end there. It was revealed that the Ford had experienced numerous problems affecting everything, from the arresting gear and catapults to its radar systems, along with problems with the ship's main turbine generators. But let's talk numbers. This supercarrier has a value of $13 billion. The MX missile was a bad military decision from the get-go. Known as the Peacekeeper missile, it could carry up to 10 re-entry vehicles, each armed with a 300-kiloton W-87 warhead in an MK-21 re-entry vehicle. It was a missile designed to help the USA in case of a sneaky Soviet attack. President Carter decided to commission the building of this missile in 1979, and officials said it would likely cost between $30 and $32 billion in fiscal 1980 dollars. Each unit of this type would cost $70 million alone, and it was optimistically trialed again and again until 2005, when they officially called quits due to negotiations on the START II treaty. Your mind might automatically jump to the sporting brand when we say Nike, but Project Nike was more focused around military weapons than a session at the gym. This project was started at one of the most highly classified, top-secret locations in the United States, a missile base called Fort Hancock. Named after the Greek winged goddess of victory, this missile was a surface-to-air missile, guided by radar and a tracking computer. Cold War paranoia over waves of Soviet bombers blasting the U.S. was the catalyst for Nike to be created, but it didn't go according to plan. Nike Ajax missiles were replaced by Nike Hercules missiles, which were replaced by Nike Zeus missiles. And each time the military released a new subtype of missile, the Soviet Union was phasing bombers out, making the missiles useless. When the project was eventually stopped, no missile was ever fired at an enemy. But at least $20 million had been spent on Nike. Not only did the Army invest $19 billion into their project called Future Combat System, but they also had to pay a sky-high $500 million in termination fees when they canceled the plans in 2011. The program included a large family of manned vehicles, as well as a range of unmanned air and ground systems and sophisticated radios, all tied to a single network and intended to give soldiers a much better view of the battlefield. The idea initially was that the Army wouldn't be able to lose a fight if they could see everything that the enemy was doing. But after realizing that it probably wouldn't be successful in places like Iraq, the program was dissolved. If there's one issue you don't want to have with an aircraft, it's a broken gearbox. And that initial problem was how the Airbus A400M Atlas came crashing down from production with one swift bang. Of course, there were other problems associated with this plane that were far more complex to sort out. Combined, the Army has spent around $21 million on this flightless fleet of planes. It was a design that caused everyone problems, from Airbus, who created the program, to Germany, the largest customer on the waiting list. Now years behind schedule, Germany's share of costs have risen from an expected $10 billion to nearly $12 billion. The irony with the creation of the Zumwalt-class destroyer was that it was actually built in a way that it would save money. But nope, it wasn't meant to be in this example. Because the Zumwalt's advanced gun system didn't work very well and its rocket-boosted Lurlak GPS-guided shells cost $800,000 each, nearly as expensive as more precise, longer-range, and harder-hitting cruise missiles. The first reports planned for 32 of these ships, but as costs overran estimates, the quantity was reduced to 3. Significantly increasing the cost per ship to $4.22 billion. The total cost looked to be in the region of $22.5 billion. Next, we bring you the Boeing Sikorsky RAH-66 Comanche, a helicopter created by the U.S. military that cost $7 billion to design and never even made it out of the planning stages. On radar, the Comanche appeared 360 times smaller than the equivalently sized AH-64 Apache plane and looked to be filled to the brim with impressive features. Boeing Sikorsky spent the next 9 years getting the RAH-66 off the drawing board. It wasn't until the middle of 2000 that the engineering and manufacturing phase began. And over the next 4 years, the team was able to produce a whopping 2 prototypes before the Army axed the project due to changing operational requirements. Let's jump back in time again to the 1930s. The Maginot Line was a line of concrete fortifications, obstacles, and weapons installations that France constructed along its borders with Germany during the 1930s. Military experts claimed that the Maginot Line was a work of genius, believing it would prevent any further invasions from the east, but they forgot one key issue. While it did prevent invasions directly from the east, it just made the Germans reroute through Belgium instead. When they got through, they defeated the French army and conquered France in about 6 weeks. And let's keep in mind that this project cost $1.2 billion, or 7 billion francs in 1930s money. The Rockwell B-1 Lancer has been struggling with mechanical issues for a long time. Almost the entire fleet of these planes currently sits on the ground due to ongoing struggles with its capabilities. And with a cost of around $1 billion per plane, it's more than a shame to see all that hard work not taking off. The Air Force is currently under pressure to sort out this fleet of planes to stop it from becoming another wasted project from the past. And if it can't shape up these existing planes, it'll have to spend even more money on commissioning new ones. Did you like this video? Our friends over at Brainiac present all the amazing facts that you wish you learned in school. From how-tos to survival tips for every situation imaginable, it's just perfect for showing off your knowledge and flexing your intelligence on your friends and coworkers. It's hilarious content you won't want to miss. That's all for 15 biggest wastes of money in the military. How many of these projects hadn't you heard of before? Let us know in the comments below. And make sure to like this video, subscribe to The Richest, and join our awesome notification squad. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.